Hi, welcome to FMS Solutions. And this is a lesson in the series of discussions we'll be having as far as introductory analysis is concerned. And I want to look at another example on the mathematical induction. So, mathematical induction. Yeah, mathematical induction, so proof by mathematical induction. So I'll be looking at another example. So that's example two. Right, so we are proving that proof, this is the question. Proof that we have 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared plus, and this will continue, n squared. We are proving that all this is equal to 1/6 n plus 1, 2n plus 1. Right, so we are doing this. We are doing this for all n belonging to the set of natural numbers. So the first thing to do here is to see whether this statement is true for the first element of the set of natural numbers, which in this case is what, 1. So for n equals 1, we want to see whether the statement is true. So you can do that by substituting 1 to the left side. If it is equal to what we have at the right side, then the proof is ample. So on the left hand side, realize that we can see n, so put 1 here. 1 squared gives us what, 1. So we have a square of 1, which gives us what, 1. But what is happening on the right side? So let's do this. The right hand side. On the right side, we have 1/6 of 1, then 1 plus 1, 2, we have finally substituting 1 for n. So this gives us 2, this gives us 3. So 3 times 2 gives us 6. So you're going to have 1/6 multiplied by 6, which gives us 1. Realize that the right hand side is also 1, as well as the left hand side. So the statement is true for the first element of the set of natural numbers. In effect, we say the proof has been got anchored. Alright, so let's look at the second step, which is the assumption step or the hypothesis step. So here we assume. So let's assume that. We are assuming that for n equals k, so where k is also an element of the set of natural numbers. So the summation, so we look at this, the summation, so from I, this time around we're looking at square of numbers. So I squared, where I begins from 1 up to k, is going to be equal to, so any place we see k, at the right hand side, we're going to start, any place you see n, we're going to write what, k. So we have half of k to 1/6 of k, then k plus 1. So we have 2k plus 1. We are assuming that this one is true. Alright, so this is true. Good. So if we assume that this statement is true, then we can base on this. So we're using this assumption to prove. So the next, so using the assumption, we are proving that, so for n equals k plus 1, now you must be reminded that k plus 1 is a successor of what, k. So for that, we're going to say that the summation, so let's have some lines, the summation I squared, where I begins from 1 up to this time around k plus 1, will be equal to, so let's see what happens here. Any place you see n, we write k plus 1. So that will be equal to 1/6. So we have k plus 1 into brackets. So if we put k plus 1, see that this place becomes k plus 2 because there is 1 there already, so we have k plus 2. And then we'll put k plus 1 here. Alright, so putting k plus 1 here will result in 2k plus 1. Meanwhile, there's another 1 here, so in effect, we'll be having 2k plus 3. Alright, so we have something like this. So we are proving that this is equal to this using the assumption as stage 2. So all that we need to do is to see if we can write this to be equal to 0, and that's all. Now let's look at the main proof. Okay. So all we're trying to say is that this side should be equal to that. So we have the summation I squared, where I begins from 1 up to k plus 1, is actually equal to. So you realize that before we can get to the k plus 1 term, then we might have passed the k term, the sum up to the k term. So we say that this is equal to the summation of I squared, where I begins from 1 up to the k, then plus the k plus 1 term. Alright. Now we have k plus 1, but we realize that in the question given to us, say that we're proving 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, n squared. It means that if we need another term, which in this case is k plus 1 term, then it should be k plus 1 squared. So for that reason, we're going to write here k plus 1 and squared. Right. So from the assumption, we've said that the summation up to the k term was equal to all this. So it's appropriate that we just leave this and put it in place of this. So it follows that this will be equal to, we have 1/6 of k into brackets k plus 1, and we have here 2k plus 1. So plus, then what we have here? It is k plus 1 squared. Now, at this point, we realize that we have k plus 1 here, k plus 1 is also here, and there is something also, we have 1/6 here. But we don't have that here, but we want to create a situation so that something is common, we factor something out. We realize that here, this place, there is a coefficient of 1, but we can manipulate this so that we write whatever is here to look like this. So plus, since we are writing 1, or 1 is here, we'll write it as 6 over 6. Now you agree with me that 6 divided by 6 gives us 1. So we've not done any significant change. So having done that, you realize that, okay, 6, 1/6 is common now. And also, k plus 1 is what's common. So we factor that out, 1/6. K plus 1 is common, so we factor it out. When that is done, we will be left with k here. So 2k plus 1. Then k plus 1, we have twice of it here, or the square of it here. So when 1 is here, it means that we have k plus 1 left here. Alright. So we have 1/6, k plus 1, and we come here. So we try and expand this. K multiplied by 2k gives us 2k squared. So we have 2k squared. And this k times 1 gives us k. So we have the k here multiplied by, because so we have k, n plus k gives us 2k plus 1. So we have something like this. Yes. So this actually is going to be equal to, so we have 1/6 k plus 1 so into brackets. So we're trying to simplify this aspect. So when that is done, we're going to have k plus 2, then 2k plus 3. Alright, so times later, we have actually done the proof. So the So from here, we rush up to this stage, and so at this point, we conclude that since this one is equal to that, we say that conclusion. So for all n which belong to the set of natural numbers, so we have in 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared and so on, n squared be equal to 1 set of n, n plus 1, then 2n plus 1. Alright, so that's our proof. Thanks very much for your attention. I'll catch you next time.